Trying to do is center this right even on that center pith. The reason is if I try to do it like this, I'm going to get probably four out of the middle there that are unusable. This way I'll only get one that's unusable. Again, I just want to try to stay centered up with that pith in the middle. So here you can see I'm just getting basically this one here, possibly this one, that'll be bad. If I'd have laid it out where this line went right down the center, I'd have got four that would have been bad. They'd all had that center pith in it, and I don't want that. So now I just go about splitting it out to those, that grid. These are about 2.5 inch squares that I need for my leg turnings, and they work out perfectly that way. The reason I leave it intact and don't just split it off is it makes it a lot harder to keep standing up to split the remainder out. The smaller and smaller it gets, the harder it is to split. I just keep on continuing on until I get all of it gridded out and split to the best I can. What I'm doing with the hatchet here, as I get it out of there, is I'm just scoring it so that it makes it easier to drive the wedge in, and that kind of helps guide the split. It kind of already makes it relieve to where it knows where it's going to want to be split. Take your time, make sure that you don't try to overpower it. You want it to just kind of naturally split on its own, go right where it wants to be. But at the same time, you want it to try to stay in line with the width that you're trying to shoot for. Now I can just use this wide wedge. This is a Shepley wedge I bought at an antique store. This is a great wedge. It's real slender, but it's real wide. It doesn't have a whole lot of angle on it, like something like that. But it's just so much wider, you can split one of these in one swoop. It's a lot easier. That one I'm not going to get much out of on that corner there, so I probably ought to just leave that one. I probably could split that in half and get two arm stumps out of it, but I'd rather get a leg out of at least one. Alright, the process just goes like that until I get it all split up, and then I'll pull them all apart, take them to the shop, and start turning them. Alright, now what I'll do is just basically eyeball down the length of it to try to center it up, and you can see that I got a wider edge up here than I do at the bottom. So what I do is just run an imaginary line down the longer side. So I mean, it'll come up something like that. So off of that to there, off of those two little pieces, I just try to eyeball where a center would be. It doesn't have to be perfect. And do the same thing on the other end. Just Just kind of eyeball the center. And that's where I know to put the center of the livestock or live head and the tailstock of the lathe. Now what I usually will do is take a nail punch and just set it in there on that spot and just drive a little hole in there. That makes it easier to set on the lathe. Now being that this one is so off-center at the top, I'll probably take the fro and just try to split a little bit more off of that just to even it up. Otherwise it'll wobble real, real bad at the lathe. Alright, so here I got my fro club, and you can see this side to here is the one that runs over a little bit more. So I'm just going to take and kind of eyeball down it and try to split a little bit more off of it. It does work sometimes, sometimes it doesn't. And that time it worked all right. So now I'll just turn that at the lathe and get it round. Okay, I've got the piece mounted in the lathe here. It's still out of balance a little bit, but we'll knock it all down. Fiddle it out of the way so it doesn't knock them all on the floor. But I've got it set on the slowest speed. I'm just going to kind of take my time to knock all the edges down, and I want about a 2 1/4 inch diameter cylinder the whole way down. See how much wobble it's got in it? That's why you want to run it at a slower speed. Piece still has a pretty good gouge stuck out of it, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to get my full diameter I need out of it. I'm at 2 3/8 right there, so I know I'm not going to get that out. The question is, will it go out to 2 inches, which is my final diameter that I need? So what I'm going to do is take the parting tool and plunge it in until I get to just over 2 inches. To see if I'll clear that, and if I won't, then I'll make this into either a stretcher or an arm stump, whichever one it'll work out for best. Okay, right there at that depth, I'm 2 inches and I'm still not clearing it. So to find out where it's going to clear, I want to check my pattern, and right there is my thickest point, so I will put that there just to make sure I'm good enough for there. If I am, then I'll use it for a leg. If not, I'll move on for a stretcher. Still getting that little clicking sound, so it tells me I'm not good. So that's going to have to be a stretcher. That's too much of a spot, I think, for... Man, that's a nice piece, so it's a shame. That's the way it goes sometimes. I'll just continue turning this down to about 2 inches now, just to make it useful for a stretcher. Get a stretcher out of that, and if not, I'll be able to get an arm stump out of it at least. So here's my drying rack. This has the turning that I've just done in the last 3 or 4 days. After they get turned all the way just round, I stick them over here and let them dry for as long as they need, just to harden up so that they're a little bit easier to turn. Now I'm ready to take one and take it over the lathe and start to turn it into a leg. Made up a pattern for the baluster legs that I turned. It's basically, I just laid a full leg on here and then traced it out and then marked the diameters and put a little notch there so I could put a pencil in there. And all I do is I'll turn the lathe on, hold it flush at the end, and then just stick the pencil in those little grooves, and that gives me my transitions, and that way every leg comes out pretty much identical. Start in the exact same place every time, and that's on that vase area. I always start right in that area right there. I don't know why, it's just the place I picked. It's the easiest place for me to keep everything in line. I guess it's just a habit for me. one chair leg all ready to go in the kiln. You can kind of see that sheen that's after the skew chisel goes over it, that sheen that it gets. That's just as polished feeling as it can be and as smooth and as slick. No need for sandpaper whatsoever. Perfect baluster leg.